Okay, here's my single wheel motorcycle trailer, and it's very light. It looks kind of long, but it's not as long as it appears without the box on it. And the little brackets that hold the box on, they're removable. There's just some very small brackets that I've got welded on here, right here on this 1¼ by 11 gauge tubing. So these can be changed out for different boxes or whatever, but this is what I've got right now. And with those off, it can be hung on the wall and not take up very much space. And yes, that's a bicycle fork and wheel right there. And believe it or not, bicycle wheels are rated for speed. As anyone knows, you know, you go down a hill on the pavement and you can build up quite a bit of speed. And so considering what I'm going to be hauling the trailer with, you know, just groceries and that sort of thing, a bicycle wheel is fine. And they're rated for a lot of weight too, so that's no problem. So why not? I had it, and so that's what I did. Also, on these forks, up inside of here, it's a 1 inch. And that happens to be, you know, this 11-gauge 1¼ tubing just happens to be slightly larger on the inside than 1 inch. So the steer tube just went right up in there. I got a level and made sure that this was going to be level. And so I tack welded it. And, of course, that held it in position while I put 2 3/8 bolts into it to actually bolt the this fork to the frame of the trailer. And that's about all there is to it. Just real simple. It's real light, doesn't weigh very much. Here's my little tail light that's required. Turn signals aren't required in Alabama, so I didn't bother with them. The simpler this is, the better it'll be. Now up here on front, to connect it to the hitch on the motorcycle, I've just got some 7-inch cold rolled steel here, bored a 1/2-inch hole in it. And of course, I bored a 3/4-inch hole through the tubing and then welded it up. And you can see my light connector there, all it's for. You know, there's a couple of unused terminals there. It's just ground, tail light, brake light. And this goes in my hitch right up here on the back. This is a under the rack hitch I made. If you'll see here, there's a couple of 5/8 bearings in there. They're flange type bearings. There's a light press fit that holds them in there, so they're not going anywhere. And the flange is on the bottom side, of course, so this bolt, 5/8 bolt, is going to hold them in there anyway. They can't come out. The hitch itself here is 1/4-inch thick, 4 by 3 inch steel tubing, and it's 3 inches long. This is a 1/2-inch holes for the pin that goes in there and hooks up to the trailer. So the pin just goes straight through. Of course, you see that turns that way, and of course the hitch can move up and down, so that's got your two axes, and that keeps it aligned with the bike so that it turns with the bike. And you can see there, there's it turns real nice and smooth on the bearings, which is important. Another thing that's very important is there's no slop in this. There can't be any play in it, you know, at all, or you're just not going to have very good results. Just not good results at all. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just take a moment here and set the camera up, and I'll hook it up. Okay, now first of all, I've got a tractor pin here that I picked up, and it's got a spring pin here, and this is what I use to connect it through the hitch here when I go to hook it up. So see, that runs right down through there like that. So what I'm going to do is put the pins up here where I can easily retrieve them, because hooking this thing up can be a bear. Okay, what you want to do is just straddle it so your legs can control the trailer and keep it level, you know, as you hook it up. And then we're going to spin this around here. Now, the first thing we've got to do is take the little harness here, wiring harness, and start it through. And then you can pull the trailer up. And then you take your pin here and start it in. And like I said, this can be tricky, but it will go in there, and it's not too awfully bad. But like I said, there's no almost no play in it. Yeah. There we go. And you take the little pin here, spring pin, put it in there, clip it, and the trailer's hooked up. Yeah, here's my box that I put on it. Of course, you know, this is what I had, and so this is what I'm going to use. It'll hold quite a few groceries, and it just fits back here on the trailer between the two brackets. So just give me a second, and I'll load it up here, and you can see how easy this. To put the box on the trailer, it's very simple. It just sits in there and then just straps down with a single strap. That's it, on there, easy. And when you get back home with your groceries, you can just take the entire box and pick it up with some help, of course, and carry the whole thing in the house.